Good morning, students. Today's class, we are going to continue that string manipulations, functions and methods. Last class, we have seen some functions. Today's, we are going to continue that functions and methods in the string. Let us learn splitting and joining of the string. Splitting means the splitting it is used to split the string. Joining means it is used to joining the string. Let us learn how these functions will work. The first one is splitting. Split function, it returns the list of words of the string as a list data type. It returns the list of words of the string as a list data type. For example, message is a variable. We have stored the value as a enter the dragon. So, in between the words, the space is there. Yes. So, what is the next step? Print message.split. What we have used here? Split function. So, what it will return? Split is to returns a list of words in the string. It split the words in the string. So, what we have passed in this arguments? Default, we have passed as a space. So, from the space, it will split the string and it will display the data type as a list. Okay, ma'am? The next example, we can use split function to split the string using delimiter also. You know that delimiter means. So, delimiter, character or characters which we want to use to split the string. By default, it will be a space. Let us see the example of this. Message equal to the same example. So, what is the next line? Print message dot split of hyphen. What is the character delimiter we have used here? Hyphen. Yes. So, from this hyphen, it will split the string. So, enter. The next one is the. Next one is dragon. And it will return the data type as a list. So, we can use delimiter also to split the strings. The next function is joining function. It returns a string in which the string elements of a sequence have been joined by string separator. For example, we have assigned the sequence of list. We have assigned sequence of list the value as a list under the dragon. Print, we have added a space dot join sequence hyphen list. What is the value of the sequence hyphen list? Enter the dragon. It is a list. Okay. So it will split the string. It will join the string using the space. So here it will add the space and it will display the result. The next example, sequence tuple equal to enter the dragon. That means, what is the value of the sequence tuple? Enter the dragon. Print hyphen dot join sequence tuple. So, it will join the hyphen here and it will display the result. So, what is the syntax for this? Joining character dot join bracket variable. So, join method, it is used to returns a string in which the string elements of sequence have been joined by str separator. Splitting and joining together, we will see one example, then you can understand clearly that. See, this is the website address, link. Okay. So, the first step is you have to separate out the query string from URL. Okay, the second step is you have to then separate out key values pass in the query string. The next one is now update the filter to views and num to 15 and from the URL again. See, your link is here. Okay, what is the variable we have stored? Link. The link value is we have stored in that variable. Next, components equal to link dot split of components equal to link dot split of question marks. It is a delimiter. We are using that character to special character to split the string. Okay. Components variable, we are going to split and store it in the components. What is that split we have used? That question mark, where it is present in that link here. So from this it will split the string into two part. Next, you display the components. So it will display the string, it will split the string and it will display the result. Can you understand this? Here the question mark is there, so it will split here and here. So it will split the whole string into two separate string, from the question mark first part, from the question after the second part. So it will display the result as a list. Okay, the second one is URL equal to components of 0. So what is the components of value here? This one. So traversing the string, what is the value here? 0, 1. So components of 0, it will store it in a value variable to URL. QS equal to components of 1. Components of 1 value what? Filter equal to commands. So this value to store it in a variable QS. Now we will print the URL value. URL value what? Components of 0. 0 value what? This, it will print the string. US components of 1. So it will print the result. Split the link using that question mark. It is a delimiter to separate the URL and query string. Can you understand this? The next one is string title method. The title method returns a copy of the string with the first letter of each word is converted to uppercase and remaining letters are lowercase. Listen ma, the first letter of the word alone uppercase, remaining word character all are lowercase. The methods does not change the original string. What is the syntax for writing this? String.title. String.title. Let us see the example of this program. Title function s equal to hello comma world. So the values stored it in a variable s. X equal to s dot title. So s dot title means what is the value of s here? Hello world. So dot title. So the title function, it is used to convert each word of the string first letter alone caps letter other than lowercase. So print x, what is the output? It will convert the first letter alone, it will convert the first letter alone capital letters other than lowercase letters. The next function is string isDatil method. isDatil method, it will return the value as a boolean value. If it is all the words first letter alone capital letter, it will return a true value. Other than, it will return a false value. Symbols and numbers are ignored. What is the syntax for using this string dot is title? Let us see the example of this string is title function. A equal to hello and welcome to my world. So this string, all the characters, all the letters are uppercase characters. So it is a capital letter. We have assigned the value to the variable A. Here the first letter alone caps and we have assigned the value to the variable B. So print A dot is title. What it will print? Because here all the characters are a capital letter. So it will result a value as a false value. Next one, print b dot is title. Here first letter alone, first character alone, it is a capital letter, so it will return a value as a true value. It will return a value as a true value. Is title function, it will return the boolean value true or false. If in the string all the words are first letter alone capital letter, it will return the value as a true value. Other than, it will return false value. The next method is string partition method. The partition function split the string at the first occurrence of the separator and returns the tuple containing three items. The split function and partition function both are same, that is used to split the string. But partition function, it will split the first occurrence of the string and it returns the tuple as a three item. The first one is the first element contains the part before the specified string. Second elements contain the specified string. The third element contains the part after the string. That means the first step is the part before the separator. The second step is the separator itself. The third step is the part after the separator. We will see the example, then you can understand clearly that partition method. What is the syntax for writing this? String dot partition net bracket separator string value. For example, text txt, it is a variable. We have stored a value as a I could eat apples all day. The value stored it in a variable text. X equal to text dot partition of apples. What is the argument we have passed? Apple. Yes. So from that apple, it will split the string. So I could, this is the first string. Next one is what? Specified string. The third one is what? After the separator. So from that partition function, what we have passed as arguments? Apples. It is a separator. From the separator, first part is what? I could eat. That is the first one. Separator itself, it is a specified string. After separator, that is all day. So it will display the result like as a tuple. Okay, so what is the difference between the split and partition function? Both are same. It is used to split the string. Split function split the string at any occurrence of the given argument, but the partition function split the string at the first occurrence of the given string. The split function, it will return list type containing the split substring. Partition function, it will return tuple type containing the split substring. Okay. Let us revise what we have completed today. The first function is split. First function is split function. It returns the string. It returns list of words of the string. Joining function returns a string in which the string elements of sequence have been joined by a str separator. IsTitle, title function, it returns in the string all the words, the first letter alone, capital letter. IsTitle function, it will return the boolean value true or false. It return true value when the string all the words, the first letter alone, capital letter. Otherwise, it return false value. Partition function, it returns the value as a tuple. It will split the string at the first occurrence of the separator. Okay, thank you students. We'll see in the next class, next chapter. Okay, thank you ma'am.